Today we're going to talk about the 3D touch on the Smart RAMPS board. Now I need to tell you a couple things about the Smart RAMPS board. I placed a jumper right here so that we can jump the VCC to the 5 volt pin, and this is our ground pin for reference. And by jumping this pin, being the 5 volt, from the VCC, we now power this rail when we have our USB connected. So this is our 5 volt rail, this is our signal pin rail, so this is digital pin 11, this is 6, 5, and 4. Then we have our ground pins. So we're going to be concerned with digital pin 11 in this row. Over here we have our end stop pins. So we have our X-min, our X-max, our Y-min, our Y-max, our Z-min, and our Z-max. Now the digital pins are on top in this case for these six pins. Then we have our ground pin in the center, and then we have our 5 volt pin on the end. In this case, actually on this board, it's 3.3 volts. So to connect this, we need to know what our wires are. So here is the one connector for the servo connector, and we have a dark wire right here, which is mostly brown. That's our ground. The center pin is orange or almost red, and that's our voltage. And then we have an orange one on the end, and that would be our signal pin. Over here we have a white wire for our end stops, and then we have a black wire. The white wire is for signal, and the black wire is for ground. So to connect this, we're going to start with our signal pin being on the outside towards the top, and we're going to connect it to digital pin 11, and then we're going to connect our end stop connector to the Z or Z min with the white pin on the signal pin. So in a moment, I'll show you how to test it after we load Marlin firmware. So before I do that, I'm going to show you how to connect the serial USB. It goes to the programming port closest to the 12 volt power supply on the bottom of the Arduino Duo, and the other end goes into the computer, so you can hear a beep. In a moment, I'll show you how to load the Marlin firmware. Okay, the first thing we want to do is open up Marlin-bugfix-2.0.x. Then we're going to open up the Marlin subfolder. Then we're going to open up the source folder and the core folder. Now we're going to open up boards.h. And we're going to do a search on Smart. So what we have here are several different versions of the Smart RAMPS configurations. We're going to use this one, being board underscore RAMPS underscore Smart underscore EFB. So we're going to copy this. Then we're going to close out of here. We're going to go up one directory, then another, and we're going to click on the marlin.ino file. Okay, now that we're in the marlin.ino file, we're going to go to the configuration.h tab. We're going to do a search on motherboard. And we're going to replace board underscore ramps underscore 14 underscore EFB with what we copied from the boards file. So we're going to paste it here. So now we have boards underscore ramps underscore smart underscore EFB. And the next thing we want to do now is search on BL touch. And what we want to do, because for define BL touch, it's commented out, so we need to remove the comments by backspacing.
Then we're going to scroll down a little, and there's a couple of settings in here you can enable if you so desire by removing the comments. Next thing we want to do is we want to search on num_servo. And this is commented out as well, so we're going to remove the comments. And we're going to change the number of servos to 1. If you had 3, then you would put a comma after the 300, add another 300, then another comma, and another 300 for 3 servos. But in this case, we only want to use 1. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to check to make sure that we have the right board selected, which we don't. So we're going to go to boards, and we're going to scroll down till we see the Arduino Due programming port, and we're going to select that. And we're going to check to see that we have a port selected. Now that we do, we're going to try and compile and upload using the upload button. In a moment, I'll show you in Pronterface how we're going to test it. Okay, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to open up Pronterface. We're going to connect to the 3D printer board for the smart ramps. And we're going to check to see what the status of our end stop is by typing M119 and pressing enter. Right now it says open for the Z min. For the X and the Y min, it says triggered because there's nothing connected. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to home the Z axis, and I'm going to actuate it with my finger so we can test it. So here we go. Okay, now that it's been triggered by my finger, I'm going to check again with the M119 and press enter. And now it says triggered. So if you like my tutorial, please like and subscribe, and thank you for your time.